Hi. Let us have a little bit of boredom after all this entertaining presentations. So we have everything for that. We have C++, we have no pictures, no videos. So if anybody is interested, I work at Mission Control Center. I am a small part of a great hand that keeps ISS on the orbit. But enough about ISS, it gets too much attention as it is. When you work on a piece of software, the first question you should ask yourself is, who needs it at all? In this case, the answer is simple. If you use Lua API from C++, you are my client. Well, metaphorically a client, because it's free software, of course. It's library which serves as replacement of Lua API for C++. And in fact, it serves also as intermediate. So the goal is for you to use the same old Lua API, but more easily, comfortable, and more expressive. It has automatic stack management, so you don't have to count the stack slots. It has a small set of objects that give you handy methods to do everything. And what is important, it has natural syntax for many operations like calls, indexing, and arithmetics. Also, as a nice bonus, it has automatic function wrapping that I will show later. The aim was to make it very lightweight, with little overhead, ideally none. I mean, no runtime overhead at all in ideal cases, which is quite easily to achieve. It requires C++ 11 to function because prior standard had no support for features that are absolutely necessary for it. It is compatible with Lua 5.1 and it passes tests with Lua JIT in that mode. And by default, it is compatible with Lua 5.2. It is open source under MIT license, so those who use it will get no confusion about licenses at all. Now I will introduce the main players. So after I finish, you will have a good idea how to use this library. First is state. It is an object for Lua state. Its main purposes are to create and destroy the state, and it lets you set up the environment by executing files, strings, and C functions. It means Lua-compatible C functions only. It can't do anything else, and we don't actually need it to. So as it is, it stands aside because it doesn't interact with the rest of the library. Everything else happens in the context of so-called L function. It is analog of Lua compatible C function, but it's specially tailored for this library. So L function receives context objects, one object actually, which lets to do practically everything Lua allows to do, except using values. You can access the environment, you can control the flow by returning values, and you can create values because it's the origin for value objects. Value objects are a bit tricky because there are different types that represent lower value, but basically they behave the same. So interaction with these objects allows you to read values, to convert to native types, to make basic operations like calls, indexation, arithmetics, comparisons, and you can receive some miscellaneous info. One important point is you can write and read metatables easily from any value. There is a special type of value objects, ENCODE. The name implies that such objects just encode a value to the stack for later use. There are three kinds of ENCODE objects. It's value itself, which is generic, it's specialized table object, and it's valve set that allows to capture a multitude of values. This library maintains open borders policy, which means that values are allowed to migrate from native to Lua and back freely. It is done with implicit conversions and so-called promotion. Promotion means that any supported value can be used in a place where Lua value is expected. Let's have a look at anatomy of L function. First, it returns special type RedVal. The idea was to enforce user to access special function red to create this value, because there's no other way to generate it. These functions allows you to specify any number of return values for your function. So if you want to return some values, you just write it like that. These function receives context object, which serves as access hub for all Lua operations. Now, you cannot directly use L function with Lua, so you need to convert it to compatible C function. This is done with MKCF, which stands obviously for make C functions, and you pass the name of your L function as template parameter. In the output, you have wrapped C-compatible function, as you see it here. And the wrapper, which is created individually for any wrapped function, but is generally the same, it generates the context object to be used by L function, and it intercepts all exceptions and convert them to Lua errors. Generally, you won't be using MKCF too much because of silent promotion of functions. That means that L function is promoted automatically like any other value and is wrapped automatically when you just supply its name. But in some contexts, like when you use state, you have to have C functions. Now about value traversal. Value can be converted implicitly to some of those supported types, practically anything that makes sense. So no conversion to nil, obviously, no conversion to wrapped functions. Otherwise, you can have C function, you can have registered user data and anything else. Any value object has implicit conversion apparatus to those supported types, and it has explicit cast function where you choose the destination type as template parameter. There's fail-safe variation of cast function. It works pretty the same, but it doesn't raise exceptions on failure, on type incompatibility. And instead, users provided backup value. There are type checking functions. One checks compatibility with native types. So if some val object holds a number or a string convertible to number, this function will return true. And there's direct type query, which just queries the type as enum. The operations with single value, it includes assignment, it's not listed here, but that's most general thing you can do, and you can enjoy automatic promotion with assignment. Also, you can do calls in natural form. You can provide any number of arguments of any supported types. There is explicit call function, which is generally the same as natural call. And there is pcall function for protected call. The temporaries produced by all operations behave honestly, so you can chain and nest all these operations freely. You can index objects again with any type of value, read and write. Also, you can read or write meta table for any given value. There is another meta table function in context itself. It works for registered user types. And you can query length of object. Interesting enough, this function differs in versions 5.1 and 5.2. But this code works in both versions because in 5.1 this returns size t directly, and in 5.2 it creates a value object, a temporary, which is silently converted to size t. What you can do with two values? You can concatenate and note how one value on one side of operation initiates chain conversion of resulting values into temporary lower values. You can do comparisons, and they produce native bool types. And in version 5.2, you can do arithmetics. I had to commandeer the power or exponentiation sign from explosive OR operation, and therefore it has lowest priority instead of highest as it should be. Now about types of values. The most basic type is valref. It's a reference to a value to already occupied stack slot, and it does not own its stack slot. So basically, it always references an anchor object. Temporary objects are actually very complex. They use proxy types that store all information to push the object on the stack or the information to perform assignment. But you don't have to worry about that because you don't even see those types. You just use temporaries as easily as you use common valref. And anchor types, we already saw those. And we will have some more meetings with them in near future. Now, about handling multiple value return. Let's suppose we have MRV object that incorporates this Lua function. The call expression is a temporary object which knows in what context it is used. So an unused call expression will expect no values and discard just everything that was returned. In a context that requires exactly one value, it expects exactly one value and discards any excess. But when it is used inside a sequence, it is expanded. So all returned values become a part of the sequence. It does not only that, not only in function calls, in any context that implies a sequence. For example, returning values from function, filling tables or whatever. And while set can be used to capture multiple returned values. In fact, it was its main purpose. So it stores not only on values, but in case of pcall, it stores the success status. If the call failed, it instead of returned values, it contains error message. While set cannot be used as a single value in context that implies exactly one value, but it is expanded just as call expression is expanded. When value set is expanded, all its values are copied. That is not like with temporaries, but there is one single special case when you return while set from the function. It is an optimized operation. It just reuses whatever while set has. The table object, it behaves somewhat like valref, but it has unnecessary operations trimmed off, so you cannot do function call on a table. You can iterate over all the values in table with special iterate function where you provide a callback that works on key value pairs. And the table has raw accessor. The most interesting things are the possibility to create array literal and record set literal. It is done by simply listing all the content you want to be put in the table. Array obviously assigns the values to progressive numeric indices. And this is a place that has sequence context. Records put values to specified keys, so it expects key value pairs, and it is a signal value context. The context object itself serves as main access point for everything in Lua, and its accessor object. Objects include global object. It is indexed with strings only and produces temporaries. The registry, it is a special thing for storing values and for storing metatables for user data. args, argument to function, is actually a constant valset object. So all the rules about valset apply with the exception that it is constant immutable. But in fact, that doesn't mean you cannot change values inside valset even if it's constant. It means only that you cannot expand or shrink it. And up values, they use normal Lua indexing. Valset uses zero-based indexing because it's STL-compatible container, and you can use STL algorithm on it, and so on. And up values are normal Lua accessor, so you can use one-based indices with that. Context has means to return multiple values. I mentioned it before, and it has tools to report errors. Error function, in fact, never returns. But to note it code properly, it is designed as a return red val. So you can use it with the return statement to make that clear. There is where function. It describes the current execution point and is default message if you don't provide any message to error function. Return values is very dangerous operation because it stops all stack control that is done by context object and by linked value objects. So the only place to use it is in return statement. You cannot, for example, store read val for later usage and so on, only in return. The function handling of context has several aspects. First, it creates closures from normal C functions, and it can create closure from L function, but that will take one up value as a reserve. To create closure, you specify the C function and any number of values that will become initial up values. You can create chunks from given string and chunks from files. Also, there are functions similar to those of state object that just execute string or file. That is pretty much the thing. Now, this is very interesting part because you can take any generic C function, or you can even take member function and provide it to wrap function. On the output, you have full-fledged Lua value, a closure that runs that function. If you provide member function, it will always expect the first argument to be of that user data type. There's sister function that just discards returned value for non-void function if the return value is of no use. Currently, this library is using automatic promotion of C functions and member functions by default. You don't need to specify a macros explicitly. The user data support, it involves two steps. First, you associate with this macro your type with identifier string. And then at setup stage, you provide meta table that serves as identifier and as meta table, obviously. The types without meta table just cannot be recognized by automatic type facilities. So if you don't specify it, you can, for example, promote user data and it will work, but you can't do casts to this type. Retrieving user data is done with same facilities as this, the usual types, but the difference is the reference is returned instead of copy. There is no implicit cast for purpose of clarity. When the two steps are done, user data is just silently promoted as other native values. Where appropriate, move constructor is used, so you don't have any excess copies you don't want. And the metatable for the newly created value is set absolutely automatically. The value is the metatable is extracted from the registry using this identifier string. Well, type check is again as simple as that. And for walk, the type needs metatable. That is pretty much it. You can get this library, this address. And for the question part, there's a nice reading, so you don't get bored too much. It's a text of Lua interpreter, which has user data support for array of numeric values. This user data is just vector. The resize is not supported for it to be short. So you can see how it is all done. We interpret any line with state object just by feeding it to run string and intercepting any exceptions to report errors. Interpret stream just feeds the lines, reading them from input. And main function creates state object. It calls the setup stage, which is needed only for that part, and interprets standard input. That's easy. This user data support just defines our user type, assigns to it string identifier, and defines some easy, simple functions that will be exported as its method. Now we have setup function, which actually does only one glorious assignment. We assign to metatable of dvec, because we do it through context, it gets written to the registry. So we assign a new table, which we immediately fill with our records. Notice how we can reuse already existing functions. For example, this add function is just method of standard vector. Because there are two add functions, const and non-const, we have to select one through static cast. We can reuse the size function as length meta method. And now we just mention it by name because there is only one version. For other versions, we write simple functions that get wrapped automatically into Lua C compatible function. Then we just assign creation function to a global variable, and we are done. Well, I'm ready for questions.
Je suis complètement fasciné par. Sorry, I'm speaking French. I'm totally fascinated by your work and your mastering of C++. It's a really big achievement, but I don't understand how it's actually used, because from my feeling, all this is easier done in Lua than in C++. So can you please give us an example of how engineers actually use your library, some real code or something?
Preferably for ISS.
It's only recent release. So currently I'm practically the only one who is using it.
But then do you have a real example of something you're doing with the library that that is easier done, because from my view, what is really strange is that you are writing C++ code that generates Lua code, right?
No, it does not generate Lua code. It generates calls to Lua API. So basically, it's a better version of Lua API, which is more usable, more expressive, and safer.
Okay, how many lines of code there?
I didn't actually count.
A lot? Is it a lot?
Well, quite a number.
Okay.
I can tell you there's a lot of angle brackets.
For sure.
How do you manage temporary and permanent stack slots? For instance, if you have a loop that returns permanent stuff, how do you remove them from the stack? Or
yes, it's an interesting question, actually. Well, temporaries are created as some kind of proxy objects, and they have very complex real types constructed by templates. And when you use one temporary in an operation, the operation of higher order, the temporary, it practically swallows the type of sub-operation, and it moves its content. And this proxy type does not, at creation, do anything. It just remembers the information how to gain access to value or how to write it. It depends on the kind of operation. For example, with globals, it has to remember just the string name, and when it is used, it already knows what to do, because when we read it, it is told to do the push. And when it is assigned, it does assign operation, which puts on the stack the key, our string, and puts any operand that has to be written. And if it's another temporary, then after the string is pushed, the temporary is told to push itself on the stack. So we have two values exactly, and we discard them in assigned operation.
Your library kind of wraps around the standard Lua C API, right? And is there something that you would like the C API to be different to make your life easier?
Well, it's already good, in fact. When I was starting to use Lua, I noticed that the API is really clear and logical. So I expected to have no more than minor problems stemming from it. And in fact, I never had any problems with it.
And just a minor question, is it possible to, I'm not sure I understood how you integrate this in a project, but can you use it locally just for like one or two function calls or?
Of course.
Yes? Okay.
This library just calls the Lua API. So after it's compiled, all you have left are calls to Lua API in machine code.
Thank you.
A bit of a general question. You mentioned early in the beginning that you use heavily features from C++ 11. So what kind of features of C++ 11 do you use that there's not available in earlier versions? That was it a big difference to make this library possible?
The library could not be done absolutely without C++ 11. The most important thing is, of course, varidic templates. That's the only way how you can pass multiple values of undetermined types. And the second very important thing is move semantics.
Move semantics.
Yes. Write value references.
Thank you.
Is the ISS rely on Lua code in any way?
Not yet.
But it will be?
Well, let's hope so.
Very good. Make sure to post the uses of Lua page then. We all will be proud, I guess. So, thank you.